Hey, can I come in for a second? Actually, I lied. I don't want to just come in for a second. I heard you come in, and I know you're gonna hate me for this, but I know you've been crying. I heard you. Yeah, well, the music wasn't that loud. Doesn't really matter anyways. You could have been blaring that stuff on surround sound, and I still would have been able to tell that something is really wrong. I texted you to see if you needed to talk or go get French fries or something. I thought I would come down the hall and see if everything was okay since you didn't answer me. I guess I know already that everything is not okay. Stupid way for me to phrase that. I guess I just wanted to check if you're handling the not okay stuff okay so far. So can I come in? But not just for a second. Can I come in and sit with you for a while? Thank you. Feel free to kick me out if you get sick of me, okay? I won't take any offense. Yeah, well, I love you too, but sometimes we need to be alone when we're feeling like shit. Other times, being alone just makes it worse. So you just keep me updated on what you need, okay? Even if it changes and you send me away just to ask for me back, it's okay with me. Well, in that case, I will just be walking back and forth the whole night, up and down our hallway, between our bedrooms. I don't care. Whatever you need. I mean, my reason for coming in here is kind of selfish. I hate seeing you so upset. Higher. Yeah? Well, if you weren't crying, then what's that on your face? Not tears? You have got a strand of hair stuck in your not tears. Let me get it for you. There. What happened to your phone? You didn't see my text, or you just weren't hungry for fries? Well, it died. Where is it? Let's get it plugged in. Is it in your purse? This one? Your phone. Did it die, like, while you were with him, or? Well, I have an external charger. I don't know if you want to see that guy again, but if you do, I am lending it to you, okay? I don't know what he said to you tonight, or what happened between the two of you. But you should never go anywhere with your phone dead like that, you know that. Even if he was just being an asshole, okay? You could have sent me a distress signal, and I could have gotten you out of there sooner. Well, that's fine. I could have been waiting in my car at the curb while you tore into him and got out of there in your own sweet time. What did you do? Uber home? You should have called me. Well, you should have. I would have come and got you. That's fine. We can argue about that part later. But as for the phone battery, you know what? Just keep my external charger. I'll order another one. How am I supposed to look out for you if I can't reach you? And how are you supposed to look out for me? You never know. I did almost see a spider tonight. Yeah, well, it turned out to be a piece of fuzz, but if it hadn't, I would have really needed you to come home and take you outside. You never would have gotten my bat signal on time. There. Now that you've got your phone charging, will you scoot over? Let me sit next to you in bed. You look pretty sad. Do you want to talk about what happened with him? It's okay. You don't have to know what to say right now. Or ever. Okay, if you never want to talk about it, we don't have to. Do you want to talk about it? Maybe I could just ask you questions. Or I could just listen to anything that you do want to share. Okay, yeah. I can do that. But if you don't feel like answering, you don't have to. Okay? Just tell me if it's a shitty question and I will never bring it up again, I swear. I guess, like, for starters, the big one is, I'm just wondering, is it like over between the two of you? Like, officially? Is that okay right there on the side of your head? See, your hair is going into your not tears again. It's okay. You can curl up in my lap and cry. It's okay. I'm so sorry. You don't think that you're gonna see him again? Do you want to see him again? Okay, stupid question. Wanting to see somebody, it just doesn't mean, I don't know that you should. I am not worried about how he's feeling. He chose this. I'm worried about you. Of course, you would still hope to see him again. No, you're not stupid. Stop. Are any of us ever ready to just never see someone again for the whole rest of our lives? You love him. You're not stupid. But do you want him to see you again? Can I be honest? Please tell me if this is not an okay thing to say, though. But I don't think that he should get to see you again. I really don't. He doesn't deserve you. He didn't deserve you ever. Why should he? What closure does he need? That's bullshit. He knows what he did. No, because he's either stupid or he knows that you're at home crying right now. And both of those things can't be true at the same time. Okay. Yeah, sometimes people do just break up. But there is always something that leads there. And it's not good shit. No one breaks up because the relationship is working out. How come he didn't take you home tonight? Why'd you have to wait all that time just to catch an Uber? It's so cold in Calais. Well, he can be upset all he wants and still treat you right, with respect. Like, 4 hours ago, you were his girlfriend. And what? Now he's not even gonna take you home, not even make sure that you're okay? Nah. He's supposed to be looking out for you, too. Yeah, well, he doesn't. That's why I'm here. Fuck him. He's not supposed to leave you standing outside his apartment, waiting on some stranger to drive you home. I'm not. Okay, well, I'm not trying to. I don't want to argue with you, but I don't agree. I really don't agree. You might be able to understand where he's coming from, but I can't. Basic human decency. What if something had happened to you? You didn't even have a phone. Somebody's got to look out and make sure you get home in one piece. You're not even in one piece tonight. You're in pieces. If not your boyfriend, then who? Your ex-boyfriend, actually. Forget the hypothetical. Something bad already did happen tonight. You're devastated. How come you can understand where he's coming from, but he can't be sympathetic to you? He just got what he wanted. He crushed you. And what? He gets to just break your heart and dump you on the sidewalk? It doesn't even have to worry about getting you home? Fuck what happens to you? Fuck how you're feeling? Fuck how I feel? Do you know how long I've watched from the sidelines while he does shit like this? I wish you had called me. I wish I was there. That's fine that you were yelling at him. You should have been yelling at him. But I wish I'd been there. Because I know I'd have a lot more to say a lot louder. Oh, I know. You can hold your own. I'm glad. I wish I could have seen it. He had it coming. No offense. Like, I mean this so gently. But I am glad that it's over between the two of you. I know you're not, baby. I know. It's okay. You don't have to be glad, but I am. I'm not trying to be hard on you. I'm trying to tell you the truth. I bit my tongue for how long about what that guy does and how he treats you. Ugh, stop. It's not like that. Okay, I don't have a lot of bad things to say about him. It's just that the bad things are pretty bad, including tonight. I don't hate him. That's not what I'm trying to say. Would you stop pulling away from me? I'm trying to talk to you. Do you want me to leave? Okay, then just stop. Talk to me. Would you look at me? Please, look at me. I'm trying to be here for you. I really want to be in this with you. I know that you're hurting. I know that you're devastated. You can't look at me when you're crying, because then I'm going to cry. One of us has to hold it together. I know. You're heartbroken. But I'm scared. You are so much better than him. I'm sorry, but you are. Look at me, you are. And I know you. I know that you're blaming yourself. And I'm worried that you're gonna hurt more than being dumped by some shitty guy should hurt. He was shitty. What, a good boyfriend should be able to break up with you well? No, seriously, I think that. He doesn't deserve to be your boyfriend. He doesn't even know how to be a boyfriend. Why are these boys getting these titles as if they would even pass the interview? Don't do this. Do not apologize for him when he's not even sorry for his own actions. He doesn't even get what he does wrong. So how the hell is he ever going to get anything right? How is he ever going to be good enough for you? There are people out there who do love you and can love you. And wouldn't send you home crying like this. That's the people you deserve to be loved by. Not this shit. Sorry. I don't know, just people. How can you say that doesn't exist? You don't know that. I can't point to them. I just know that it's possible. Maybe not right now. Maybe sooner than you think. Like closer than you think. Okay. You're right. I'm sorry. I'll stop. Okay? He makes me mad. He hurt you. But I don't want to make anything worse for you, okay? We don't have to talk about it if you don't want to. I don't have to talk about him. And you're right. I don't have to encourage you. You are right. This is devastating. This is loss. This is grief. And I want to honor those feelings with you. Even if I hope that somebody could love the fuck out of you someday. I won't say it. I won't say it again, I swear. Do you want me to leave? Do you want me to sleep in here with you tonight? Don't worry about that, okay? If you can't sleep, I won't sleep. Well, then we will just stare at the ceiling together all night. Or I'll scratch your back the way that you like. Scoot over. Make some room. Well, unless you want to go sleep in my room where the bed's bigger. You're gonna have to let me squish in behind you. Scoot your butt. There you go. Yeah, that's good. Just get comfy. Okay, I'm not going anywhere. I know it's not okay, but I'm here. I'm not gonna leave you. You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to, okay? You don't have to tell me any of it. Stop it. No, I'm not gonna listen to you say that about yourself. Yeah, you keep talking like that, I'm gonna squish you in this bed, I swear to God. Or I'll go back to shit-talking your ex. And I told you, I have a lot more colorful things I could say about him. I also have his phone number. So unless you want him to get a raging call from me tonight, avenging your heartbreak, you stay in this bed with me. Got it? I won't. They're all empty threads. Well, I can't promise what words and thoughts I will or won't have if I do run into him in person. But for now, I'll leave it alone. I swear. I promise. But that means that you can't shit talk yourself either, okay? This is not your fault. Wouldn't matter even if it was. We don't have to debate that right now. I can prove myself right later. Can I tell you something? I don't know if it makes sense. I don't know if it's stupid. But it shouldn't feel like this. Being loved by somebody shouldn't hurt like this. You and I both know this is not the first night that you've come home crying from it. Love shouldn't hurt you. You don't have to believe me about that right now. Maybe I'll, or somebody will get to teach you. Show you someday. And get the hair out of your face for you. You so don't have to believe anything I'm telling you right now, but I'm just gonna keep telling you, okay? Just don't believe yourself about it right now either. Okay? Everything that you're thinking about yourself, don't believe it. I'm not going anywhere. Unless you want me to. But then I'm coming back. Every damn time. I swear. I love you. And get your butt back over here. You weren't supposed to scooch that far away. You know the drill. When life is shitty, we spoon it out. So come here. I know you did not get into this bed wearing jeans, did you? They're damp. It's raining out. Mm-mm. I am not spooning your wet denim. Take those off. Get something warm to wear. Am I gonna have to drag your ass back out of this bed? Get some damn pajamas on. And then get back here. We've got it back to scratch.